So I did one thing, and because of this, suddenly everybody thought I'm become some kind of an enemy. But you know, family drama started, my mother started crying. So once a month, I went to college just to check if they're keeping their part of the deal. What was aimless wandering, now it's become formidable knowledge.
Speaking of schooling and parents and careers, you know, we're in an age where there's so many different offbeat careers coming up. As YouTubers, we get this question all the time, you know, how did you talk to your parents about it? How do we convince our parents about this really new career that we have? I want to ask you, you know, if you had to convince your parents and tell them that this is what you, or what, how did that discussion go? Did that happen where you had to sit them down and tell them that this is what I'm going to do for the rest of my life?
I want to do YouTube now. Like, did that happen with you too? Doing YouTube right now.
Not everybody can be convinced about everything, okay? Some things are just done. So, just to give you an example, when I passed my 12th standard, at that time it was called PUC. After that, I decided I will educate myself. I don't want to go to college. This is a family where everybody is educated. Not going to college is like sacrilege. At least today, there is a little more flexibility. Those days, it's like if you don't go to college, you're finished. Because now, probably if you don't go to college, you may lose your lifestyle, but you won't lose your life. That was a generation, if you don't go to college, you lost your life, you're on the street, that's about it. So they were terrified of this. My father being a physician, he was just freaked about it. He is a very studious man, all his life, first, second, third in everything that he has done. So he couldn't believe this, that I want to educate myself. So I did one thing. And because of this, suddenly everybody thought I'm become some kind of an enemy. And they were not even talking to me properly. I did one thing. I was a just to tell you, I was such a big eater. I would eat 10 times, at least 10 times of what I eat today. But I never was putting on weight or anything, but it's because my level of physical activity was such. I could just run up a coconut tree, I was made like that. So, I was every day cycling about 50-60 kilometers, swimming in the Kaveri and going back like this, so eating this. I decided to go to the Mysore University library. Every day when they open at 9, I went, 8 in the evening they close. That entire time, I sat there, read all kinds of stuff. From Homer, to popular mechanics, to National Geographic, to literature, to geography, this, that, whatever. Whatever came my way, every day for 1 year, I read like this, just all kinds of things. But the most important thing for me was, though I was such a huge eater at that time, this 1 year I went without a meal. Morning I ate as much as I could, breakfast at home, and I went there and sat there the entire day without a meal, which was a huge achievement for me, because without food I could stay. This kind of expanded my way of looking at life, but you know, family drama started, my mother started crying. When the next academic year comes, go to college, go to college, go to college. Then I said, if I must go to college, I'll go for literature. My father said, what will you do reading poetry? You must become a doctor, he has seat ready for me in the military medical college, everything. I said, no. Then they said, okay, at least do engineering. Then I said, see, if I say I don't want to be a doctor, if you told me become a veterinary doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, at least a witch doctor, I would look at it. If I say no doctor, you say engineer, I'm not going to listen to this. Your problem is society, your problem is not me. So I just went for literature, and these 3 years, I went there in the beginning and they all had ready-made notes, the teachers, they would read. and everybody writing down. Those days fountain pens, kara 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 kara, it makes noise, it just irritated me. I said, I don't want to listen to this kara kara noise. I gave them a suggestion, if you give that notes wherever you got it, we will photocopy it and give it back to you. We don't have to come, you don't have to come. Then it… you know, if I'm there, I'll ask 100 questions. So they didn't like it, then I made a deal with all the teachers that they'll give me attendance, that was my only concern. So once a month I just… once a month I went to college just to check if they're keeping their part of the deal.
My life is so similar.
So I explored the geography of Mysore district in such a way, every village track, every hill that is there, every little bird nest, whatever is there, everything I paid attention, just wandering aimlessly. But today, like when I went for the Rally for Rivers board where all the top experts are there, some questions came up and I just telling them casually, they said, Sadhguru, how do you know all this? I said, what was aimless wandering? Where I paid absolute attention to everything, from a worm to an insect to anything and everything I paid attention, now it's become formidable knowledge. I never intended to learn anything, I just paid attention because it was life. And this is all it takes.